Bam. 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 Hey, everybody. Dr. Carlo Ojeda, emergency physician with DrER.TV. In this video, we're going to talk about a whole bunch of different cases as you saw in the preview before. I hope you enjoyed. And stay tuned till the end of the video where I'm going to rant on one of the viewers' comments on one of the latest videos I put up. This patient presented with a wax impaction. She couldn't hear out of her right ear. So I took one of our mid-level providers who had not used yet this elephant ear irrigation system and was teaching him how to use this device to clear a cerumen impaction. As you can see, you introduce the soft tip into the canal, and all you do is pretty much just like a sprayer, you use the manual handle to push and squirt the water through the blue tube and into the ear canal. Once it goes into the canal, it creates both high pressure and a turbulence that helps break the clot of wax and then bring it out by pressure. So you can see we're obtaining a lot of particles right away. As we continue to irrigate, you'll notice that the fluid or water coming out is almost as clear as the one going in, at which point we know that we cleared off the canal and there's nothing else to watch.
Wow. That's amazing.
Is there still
it's completely gone. It's completely everything's gone.
All right.
This second case is a patient who presented with a large mass on the left side of the chest. I mean, this is a fungating mass that's been growing more than a month, actually more than a couple months. And the patient finally presented to the ER because she finally told the family about it and they insisted she come in. At time of presentation, patient had a low-grade temperature, at an elevated heart rate. It was really smelly, and you can see there's some redness on the side of the fungating mass. Patient was admitted to the hospital under IV antibiotics, and the mass was excised successfully the next day by surgery. It ended up not being cancer, but rather an infectious etiology. This next patient is a young female patient who was playing flag football on Thanksgiving, and of course she hurt her left thumb. You can see clearly that the bones are not aligning, and I'm showing you my hand to show you how the finger was dislocated, just kind of taking your thumb and pulling straight back. And then you can see on the AP film, you can barely see the dislocation. It looks really good, right? But when you do lateral film, that's when you see the clear dislocation. So it teaches you that always look at AP and lateral films, not just at one film, but look at both, okay? Here I'm showing you how I reduce the dislocation. I just grab the end and I hold onto the thumb and pull. Use my thumb to push on the metacarpal bone and then push just like I'm doing there. It took a lot of pressure to do that, but we were successfully able to reduce that dislocation. This next patient presented with severe sore throat, and as you can see on the picture, it's very abnormal, so I wanted to show you this. A whole bunch of little ulcerations all over his oropharynx, uvula, soft palate, and so on. So this is a young patient without any other comorbidities or medical problems. So we treated him with Tylenol, we gave him some Motrin, we gave him some oral steroids that decreases the swelling and soreness, and it usually acts within a couple hours of that oral dose of prednisone. In terms of diagnosis, yes, we could have done a strep screen, but he had a low center criteria for strep throat, and I've never seen strep throat present with this multiple little vesicles. Strep throat is usually like exudates and tonsillitis and stuff like that. So we think this is a viral pharyngitis, therefore no antibiotics are needed. Just symptomatic treatment with pain medicine, lidocaine, and things to help with the soreness of the throat itself. Patient had no blood work done in the ER. He was just treated empirically and discharged home. This next patient presented to the emergency department within 12 hours of a previous ER visit. Initially, he had a localized rash over his back, but then during the day progressed to what I'm going to show you next. On the side, he has multiple other similar vesicle lesions extending across his upper chest into his right side only. And that's what's very characteristic, very important to notice in this rash. And then I noticed on the front part of his chest, he has a similar lesion there. So I asked him, do you have any others? And there it is, all over his side. This is very typical and very characteristic of shingles. So initially, it was treated just as a nonspecific rash. Obviously, by the time the rash progressed, it's very typical, very characteristic of shingles. So there's really no nothing bad that they missed, but the patient had to come back and get properly diagnosed, so that's not good. And that's why I want to share this, because rash do change, and then they might become more typical, more easy to diagnose, and I just want to show you how that progressed there. So this is a severe mid-abdominal pain. A patient presented with mid-abdominal pain that is severe. This is the CT scan, and you're going to notice right away there's a severe abnormality right there in his mid-abdomen. Look how big that, whatever that is, and within it there's contrast, but the contrast doesn't cover the whole content of that area. It's not all of it. That means there's a tear in the abdominal aorta. This is an abdominal aortic aneurysm. We're looking at a sagittal view of this patient with this abdominal aortic aneurysm, or triple A. And you can see going back and forth that you can see the contrast within the circular structure there in the abdomen, but not all throughout, because there's clot within the wall, or the dissection is not complete, so you can see it within it. Here we're going through the aorta as we're going down into the abdomen at the level of the kidneys. You can see this big, big abdominal aortic aneurysm there. There is no contrast in this picture of the view. You can see, I'm going to go ahead and measure it. Anything more than 3 centimeters is considered an abdominal aortic aneurysm. This is 10 centimeters in size. And there's definitely thrombi in addition to the dissection, calcification is going into both pelvic arteries. So guys, anybody who follows my channels knows what I'm about. I'm not about showing off. I'm very humble, I think. Well, maybe now I'm just by saying this, I'm not. But I try to be real. The reason I post videos is because I'm proud of stuff that I've done, and not because I'm showing off necessarily. Some of the things I'm actually embarrassed about. I made mistakes. I made errors in judgments. Or things like that. And I just want to share because there's plenty to learn. And what better way to learn than other people's mistakes rather than your own? So I don't know if you remember, but about a week ago, I posted a video about how I paid off a large amount of money in just 1 year by following Dave Ramsey's steps. And the point of it is not the quantity or the amount of money, the fact that I was able to undo what took me 12 years to mess up. And that's the point of the video, that even though I'm a physician, I'm very well paid, granted, is that I messed up so bad because I lived like a doctor. I bought a house, I moved, and without selling the house, I bought another house. I had a camper, I had credit card debt, I had student debt, I just had debt. And finally, I was placed in one position with my wife's illness where I had to downgrade the amount of shifts, and all of a sudden I was like, I'm not going to make the monthly budget. I'm not making enough to make up for all my debt. And that was my aha moment. I said, I have to do something now. I have to change my lifestyle. I have to live like no one else. Now I gotta get this corrected. And that was the point of the video. It wasn't showing off. It was about, I did something awesome by really tightening my budget, living like not like a doctor, selling my camper, paying off the debt, and working a whole lot more than I ever worked before. 50% more shifts than ever before. And then, you know, I'm trying to do this good, share with you all, and then I get this message from a user. It says, $250,000 in 11 months means you have sufficient income to do so. Of course, sure, I agree. Again, it's not about the total amount, but you know what that makes you? And you can see it, an effing retard. Am I a retard? Well, I'm going to give that to you. Yes, I was a retard in terms of money, in terms of what I was doing with it. This is nothing impressive. It is impressive, not by the amount. I get it. Another person with a much lower income percentage-wise, they might have paid much more percentage-wise than their yearly income. But the point is, I work hard. I put all in debt. I stopped living like a doctor and live on a schedule to the point that this coming year, I'll be able to downgrade my shifts. I'll be able to spend more time at home, not so many shift work, and have all my unattached debt. I still have two houses to pay for because, yes, I was a retard. And I bought a house before I sold the other one. And then I bought another one. I still have that one. Oh, I'll just rent it. It'll be an investment property. Well, I'm in no position to do that when I don't even have retirement yet. But because of those changes, I am now in a position that as soon as I sell those houses, I'll be able to start putting money on a retirement account, 401k, and I'm 41. By the time I'm 55, that's my goal, I'll be semi-retired or completely retired because I put money down and I'm going to live within my limits, within my goals. And that's the point of the video. It's not that I'm a effing retard. Well, maybe I was. You know what I mean. Anyway, the point was sharing with you all that I did something pretty awesome, something I'm really proud of, and more importantly, share with you my mistakes of living the wrong way before I realized that I shouldn't keep doing that. So anyway, that's the point. I wanted to reply to this person that called me an effing retard and say, just take the F out and I'll agree to the second part of the insult. Otherwise, take care, God bless, and don't make my mistakes. Live like no one else now, like Dave Ramsey say, so you can live like no one else in the future. Save money and don't buy a camper.